blue one black. People, don't forget to hit the like button to help this channel.
Thank you, blue one black. I definitely don't tell people to love me as much as they should. Hit the like button, hit the like show, subscribe to my channel. Thank you so much. Hey, everybody. How are you? Good evening. Welcome to the What Would Jeff Do Q&A show. Live on YouTube, YouTube Live. It is show number 491. What day of the week is today?
Monday.
Happy Monday, everybody. How are you? And all right, guys, how are you? My name is Jeff Gellman of Sally Canine Training. I have a dog training facility and rehab center up in Providence, Rhode Island. I personally travel the world doing dog training seminars. Actually, in 2019, we've got almost a 20, there's 16 posted. I got four more in the works. We'll have at least 20 of them planned right now. That includes the United States and Canada. And I'm working on some international ones. So I might just do one or two international as well. We work with really challenging dogs up in Providence and then at all my seminars. So we specialize in human aggression, dog aggression, a lot of leash reactivity, some extremely bad unwanted behaviors. Most people come to us because they don't know how to stop an unwanted behavior. My seminars are geared towards a lot of just like how to stop unwanted behaviors. That's why everybody comes there. You know, obviously we teach all the basic commands as every dog trainer is capable of doing or should be capable of doing. You know, you're obviously, you know, sit, you know, down, place, walk on a leash politely. But walking on a leash politely, most people actually struggle with that. A lot of people have gone through full dog training and they still struggle with that one thing. A lot of leash reactivity is what is also our specialty. The gist of this show, if you're brand new, is a couple of things. It's in Q&A format. You can ask your questions down below where it says say something. Right below that is a dollar sign. Dollar, dollar, make a holla. The way that YouTube Live works, the way to YouTube Live is where you actually support us, support our channel, actually. You don't have to support us by clicking on that. And you're a couple of different benefits. Number one, you can show that you appreciate the 5,000 videos, 10,000 hours of audio content that can fully rehabilitate your dog that you've been watching for free. And you can if you want to, or that you just really appreciate, you know, the work that we're doing. You can also do that. And then your question goes up to the top. If you can hear me talk a lot about the word punishment, the reason why I talk about the word punishment a lot is because everyone's asking me on this show here how to stop an unwanted behavior. The only way to stop an unwanted behavior is through the application of proper punishment. We teach that. There's actually a proper way to do it. You don't yell, you don't scream, you're not mad, you're not angry, but there's a proper way to do it. Don't be misled, don't be lied to. People that out there are actually trying to pass laws, ban tools. There's actually laws that they're trying to pass that says you can't say no to your dog. If you're not aware of this, start reading, start learning, start speaking up. It's pretty, pretty sad, actually, what's going out there in the dog training world with the pretty much social justice warriors taking over all of these animal rights groups under the implication that pretty much they don't want you just to own a dog. That's what it really, really boils down to. So here we go. We've got Dog Works. Love y'all. Thank you for the free content. That was a super super chat. And let's start out with Linda. This is Linda. She is my wife. She doesn't do dog training. No. I get her for an hour to an hour and a half every Monday.
Are you hinting at something?
Well, it's 9:30 is the cutoff date. Let's go. Let's get right into the questions.
This one's from Josh. Hi, love you both. Have an awesome show.
Awesome. Hey, thanks, Josh. Thank you.
Carol had 11-month-old dog to vet for weigh-in.
Yep.
We go to familiarize dogs with sounds, smells, etc. to reduce stress.
Sounds good.
We had to have a tech verify microchips for lifetime licenses. Ember reacted by first barking aggressively when Loki was scanned. I corrected, but was too late, caught off guard. Then, when it was his turn, he screamed like he was being tortured. How should I have handled it better?
What you can do is this. Role play it at home. Vets are very stressful offices. Were both dogs? Oh, yeah. Both of your dogs were at the vet? I would have only brought one in. I don't know if one in the – they're both in the – so I would do one at a time, but I would role play all this stuff. So getting your dog familiar at the vet, but that wasn't familiar because they verified the chips. They actually did stuff. They did stuff. So you could have done that instead. So what you want to do is not have any techs handle the dog. A lot of dogs are stressed when they go to the vet. And when dogs are stressed, they do stupid stuff. The audible was unnecessary audible. The screaming is like nothing's going on. There's like, you don't need to scream right now. So it's nonsense. Bring in one at a time, role play. But I would role play handling of your dog as well. Next.
This one's from Jake.
Okay.
When correcting a dog with e-collar, do you say no at the same time you press the button, or do you say no, then follow with a command and press the button as you say the command?
Okay. Two different questions with two different answers. One you're asking about the word no, and one you're asking about the word command. When you're saying no, you say no first, you mark it, and then you apply the punisher. When you're teaching you what your dog to do, you say yes, and then you offer the reward. Got it? So marking it of yes and no is what's really the most important thing. The timing of the reward, it's actually not as important. The timing of the punisher is actually not as important. It's the word no. But the dog has to learn what yes means and no means for it to be effective. And then as far as commands, though, that's different. First of all, no on a remote collar, shock collar, should be higher. It should suck. When you're training the dog, it's on a lower level. It's we call it either the working level or the perception level. You can call it whatever you want, but it's a level where the dog will feel like leash pressure level. So not bam level, just like guidance level, but you're also using leash pressure. And we do that on continuous at a lower level. I've got videos that explain that in full and my YouTube channel. Next.
Next one's from...
Super chat. Oh, guys, also, if you don't subscribe to this channel, subscribe to the channel and turn on your notifications. So hit subscribe and turn on your notifications. You'll get alerted whenever we upload content. We upload a ton of content. $14.99 from Shalonda M. Six-month-old bulldog. I mentioned him on Saturday. He's exhibiting some food aggression. Guessing that was the problem with the previous owner? Not necessarily. Don't pass the buck. He's fed in the crate, will growl if dogs walk by. Okay. It has nothing to do with the other owner. Nothing whatsoever to do. Because you know why? I see that with behavior out of dogs who owners have owned since the dog was 8 weeks old. Now who do you blame it on? The breeder? For all we know, the dog was great with the owner. Maybe not. Maybe you created it. It doesn't matter. It can be stopped. Got it? Solution-oriented, not problem. Got it? So what I want you to do is, this is how you fix it. Number one, why are dogs walking by the dog when it's eating food? Why are not all the dogs in their crates? Why are they all not eating food at the same time? Why don't you wait till everybody's done? Remove their food bowls, take them out of the area, take them out of their crate, and then finish. Now, that's what I do. That's what we do. That's what, in my opinion, is multi-dog household proper management actually is. Now, fuck you, Jeff. That's not what I want to do. I want to feed my dogs any way I want to. Okay, fine. Personally, I wouldn't have a growling dog out with another dog, but if the growling dog's in the crate, but let's say it's not. You put your growling dog on a back tie and you feed the dog, and then you walk another dog past that dog with on a leash, though. If the dog growls, you would say no and correct the dog. When do you not correct the dog for growling? If one of your dogs walked up to the food bowl and your dog growled. Now, do we correct or don't we correct? I say no. We're talking about canine-canine interaction, not canine-human interaction. Okay? Because if not, the dog that walked up will become a food stealer. So growling then tells the other dog, get the Frank Sinatra away from my food. But that's why I don't even like to muck it up. Feed dogs in crates. But that's how you fix it. Next.
Next one is from Patrick. Good evening. I hope Romy is doing well. Thank you for everything you do and keep up the amazing work.
Romy is fine. She's back from the ER. It was a heck of a 24 hours and she's doing well. Thank you so much. And you guys can just check us out on Instagram. Check out my Instagram stories, and I don't get into it in detail, but I get into it. Next. And thank you for all the people that actually... hundreds of people that send me well wishes. Next.
Kaylee. I had a random dog run up to me and my dog while on a walk today. Stayed calm and stomped at the ground once. The dog got too close. He backed away and his owner came to get him.
Awesome. Next time, kick him. Mm. And a lot of people will struggle that. They're like, what? Oh my God. Don't kick the dog. It's like, well, you know, the thing is, if you don't, then your dog can get attacked. So good job. Good job on you. Proud of you. That's actually excellent. Next.
Melissa says, hello, Jeff and Mrs. Gellman.
Hey. Hey, Melissa, how are you?
You have another one up top.
Oh, right? $5 top chat. Yeah. Mariah L. Mariah, thank you so much. Love you, hon.
$3.99 from Dog Works.
Oh,
love y'all. Thanks for your free content.
We did that one already.
Oh, I didn't know.
Yeah, if it's less than $5, it doesn't go up to the top of the queue. So I saw that right at the beginning. Don't worry about it.
It's probably in a days.
It's okay.
Shaw.
Yep.
When to press the e-collar.
So Shaw, I sort of answered the question above, but Shaw, depends on what you're trying to do. If you're trying to teach your dog a obedience command, your dog, first of all, your dog should be on a leash. Guys, I'm going to post up a YouTube video response. My YouTube videos allow comments now. Anything new from a week or 10 days ago or a week ago on allows comments. I give a really good explanation about the remote collar. And I'll probably put that, I think Joelle's turning that into a post. And because I really want folks to see how I worded that at the time. I was at the gym and when I'm on the elliptical, I get a lot of different work done. I didn't answer that question at the gym, but I actually asked that question. I answered a bunch of questions at the ER. If you're trying to train something, so say you're trying to train the word, the command sit. What we do is we have a leash on the dog. And if we want to train the command sit, we'll normally just hold the leash up with pressure. We can use a food lure. You can do that. You can put two fingers on the butt. You would say sit, and then you apply your leash pressure. You do that. Now what you can do with the remote collar is you say sit, gently hold your leash up, push the continuous button down at the working level, the lowest level that the dog feels, and the dog feels. So pressure on, pressure off when the dog does the command with leash guidance. If you just stood there and if you said sit and pushed a button or a couple hundred, the dog then just, you stop prompting, and you would only go to correction. And when you go to correction, you put the leash back on. But I've got, watch my how-to videos, my do-it-yourself videos on YouTube. All right, next.
This one's from Jake. Hey, guys, I have four dogs that are remote collar trained off-leash, and they do well, but two of them are leash reactive on a walk. Should I start working with them individually, then walk them together?
Jake, absolutely. And what I would do is at the beginning of the walk, high correction, set the tone. Mm-hmm. We got Canadian 1399. Hey, Jorge, how are you guys? I'll be up in Vancouver, British Columbia, and Collingwood. Coming up, go to jeffgellmanseminars.com, jeffgellmanseminars.com. We just announced last week, Atlanta, Vancouver, and Las Vegas, Flamingo Hotel on the Strip. So my girlfriend took the dog to a family dinner. It's already going downhill from here. I'm afraid to keep going. And there were people there that didn't like dogs and he was jumping on them. Mm-hmm. That's your problem now all of a sudden though. Any suggestions on how to use e-collar and not freak out others or suggestions? First of all, why were you taking your out-of-control dog to a family dinner? That's what I would say. Jorge, I'm going to call you on your shit. Sorry. I know you just donated $13.99 Canadian, but that's even more so I should call you on your shit. Your dog shouldn't be jumping on people before. Don't use your family's dinner guests as guinea pigs for stopping an unwanted behavior. The dog should have already been a non-jumper before the dog got there. Got it? Because how do you fix it? Remote collar, leash on, let the dog jump on people, make it suck. The dog will make an audible. That's how you fix it. If you can do that with your family friends, role play. You're probably gonna have to take them out to dinner afterwards though. So rightly so, they should have been upset. They should have been actually pissed off at your girlfriend. I would have been. So I don't wanna go to a family dinner and have some dog jumping on me. So just think about it that way. Think about it that way. It was going to happen because it hasn't been stopped. So that's what you do. Find other people to test it on. Test it on each other. In my opinion, and this is what I do, everything I do is either in my opinion or a lot of it's based on actually proper dog training, how do you train a dog, proper methods. What you'll do is you go to, whenever I would bring my dogs to somebody's house, they will immediately go lie down somewhere. Immediately. My dogs will not be walking around your house. My dogs will not be interacting with guests at all. They will be come in, lie down, just like they are right now. So I've got three dogs next to me, all lying down. And that's when instead of post on a prong collar, and about how just why you have to watch the little 1 minute clip. It was from an old podcast just about like so many people are just starting to use it as they should. And it's making their life so much better. Next.
Leah. Hi, client has three dogs. I've been e-collar training, exclusively use mini educator, and client chose the 900 series for ease of having all three dogs on one remote. Thoughts on choice, clients not experienced.
Yeah, I mean, the 900 throws me off because the dial is opposite of from going up to down. You don't do it what I naturally would think it would go. It's counterclockwise. But other than that, I mean, it is a four-dog system. It's a four-dog system. It is a low. It goes from low to medium as far as the power of it. It's practical. I mean, the only other alternative would have been for a two mini educators, one being a one dog, one being a two dog. So I have no problem with that at all. My timing on those are not as good though, because I haven't used them that much. My timing on the 300 is good. My timing on the Dogtra is good. Personally, I'd rather use a dog. I would switch over to a Dogtra if you want to do multiple dogs, but that's fine. It's fine. The technology is the same on it. Next.
This one's from Shaw. Before, after pressing the e-collar switch are at the same time.
Shaw might have wrote that before I answered the question.
Okay.
Okay. Next.
Regal Mommy. Hey, Jeff and Linda, happy holidays. Wanted to ask you, how do you gauge why dogs may be dog or human aggressive? How can you tell if it's fear-based, prey drive, et cetera?
Believe it or not, being a family pet dog trainer, I don't usually look into the why. Usually. Which sounds like, you need to know why. No, you don't. You need to know how to fix it. That's all you need to know. Now, if a dog is fearful, okay. We'll work on the confidence building. So if a dog is being afraid and then biting, you bite me, you bite me. Got it? It doesn't matter. Next.
Blue one black, doing great, Mr. and Mrs. Gellman. Sorry, I missed that one. Cottonflower too. How high should the level be on the e-collar for a proper correction for leash reactivity? I time it right, but it doesn't seem to be enough. Should I bring it to the point where he yelps or something?
So Cottonflower, stop looking at the numbers. Pay attention to the dog, and you've answered your own question. I'm really trying to get people to think on their own here. I really want everybody to think on their own. You can ask me as many questions as you want, but I want people to do the work. If you didn't see what number was there, if you weren't so number focused, and you paid attention to the dog, and you knew when you pushed that button for leash reactivity and your timing was right, which means before the dog, when the dog first alerts, you know instinctually, if that's a word, instincts, your instincts would kick in and you would dial up the number. When would you stop? Common sense would tell you when the dog changes its behavior. Got it? Then, if you want to look at the number for frame of reference, you go right ahead. So the next time you're ready. Does that make sense? I want everybody to think. Your dog's barking at the front door. Look around for shit to throw at it. Say no, throw. Pillows, shoes, a bonker. I want everybody to take back dog ownership. Next.
Okay, blue one black. Doing great, Mr. and Mrs. Gellman. It's amazing you get to still be here talking sense these days, and we get to hear you here in Europe.
Isn't it fantastic? I love it. Thanks for joining. Next.
David, just saying howdy from Arizona. I'm sure we'll have a question later. LOL.
David Smith, thank you.
Jorge, love you guys. My dog is currently dealing with anxiety or fear of coming down the stairs because he has felt a couple times for skipping steps.
Yep.
Any suggestions? I don't know if it's on your field of expertise.
Yeah, up and downstairs is on my field of expertise. Put a leash on the dog. I would usually start at the bottom of the steps. Let's go. Walk up. Get at the top. Start at the top of the stairs. Let's go. Walk down slow. Don't let the dog race in front of you. So it's almost like you're heeling the dog down the steps. Go one step at a time. Make the dog work. Next.
Hey, Jamal. Jamal says, good evening, Gellmans.
Jamal. Oh, there you are. Hey, Jamal. How are you, buddy?
Next.
Sorry.
Chevy. Hi, guys. Glad to see you.
Chevy, how are you?
Amy. Took my new dog for a walk. She is 4 years old and has never been for a walk. 15 minutes on prong collar and she was walking like a dream. Thanks for all your help, your tips. Her easy educator comes in tomorrow.
Amy, you're preaching to the choir. Keep preaching. Prong collars are the most fantastic tools out there. Everybody's so worried about using them. Everybody's afraid of what Aunt Betty's going to think. Or if they use them, they're afraid of speaking out about it, speaking it. So many people, there are people that are actually against the tools. Absolutely. In my opinion, that's fine. Let them be. But if you're against them because you think they hurt the dog, you're wrong. You have the wrong information because they don't. But so many people are not using them because they're worried what other people will say or think. Do you know that there are countries out there where when you say something possibly wrong, that somebody will come in the middle of the night and take you and you will never be seen again? There are countries out there where then you speak up for your rights and you speak up for your passion and you speak up for your convictions, you can be taken away in the middle of the night. Why are you worried about what Aunt Betty's going to say that you put a fucking prong collar on your dog? And why are you afraid to talk about it because you're worried about what Aunt Betty's going to say and your neighbors are going to say and everybody else is going to say and think? We live in the freest country in the world. And that doesn't just mean United States, Canada, but whoever hears my show, we live in the freest country of the world. You live in the freest country. We're historically most likely you can do these things. Think about it. Next.
This one's from Kaylee J. My dog doesn't seem to ever completely settle down on place. The second I get up from my chair, he looks ready to bolt off like he's waiting for a command, even if I'm just going to the kitchen. Oh, it's continued.
Next.
For something. We do tons of duration work every day. What can I do to get him to a calmer state?
You correct that. Correct it. You role play it and correct it. It's what I do. What do I do? Stand up real quick. The dog looks like it's ready to go. No, correct with a remote collar. That's exactly what you do. Pretty soon your actions won't mean anything. All right? Do that. That's what we do. Next.
Sally at sea. I have a Springer Spaniel who will not drop. She's not food motivated, so it's hard to exchange for a higher value reward. She normally would drop for a ball because she's obsessed, but not working. I think that's it.
Okay, so listen to me. I'm glad your dog doesn't work for a higher value item. Drop it, because that's a stupid fucking concept to do. This isn't JCPenney's. We don't exchange. We don't swap out. You want to train your dog to not let go of a ball? Train it to never let go of the ball unless something of higher value is there. Guess what? You've trained your dog to hold on to a ball unless it's rewarded. Now you're fucked. That's what people are doing. You're literally using positive reinforcement to train ball holding. I'm not even going to go there with that one because it's too fucking easy. And that's so unlike me because my mind is always in the gutter.
What about holding balls?
Yeah. Thank you. So, remote collar on the dog. Have the dog come over to you. Recall the dog. Say the word out. Tap the button. How high? Oh, you'll know. The dog will drop the ball. Simple concepts. Won't the dog hate the ball? You ever seen my dogs play fetch? You ever seen them drop a ball? Seems to be working for me, okay? Same with all the other dogs we're working with. Nothing I suggest will harm your dog. Nothing I suggest doesn't work. Now, does it work with every dog? No, it doesn't. But then I got five other things that I'll suggest. But that works with almost every dog out there with no negative shrapnel effect whatsoever. So you can use out for dropping a ball, playing tug, a bite sleeve, a bite suit. Dog picks something up off the ground. If you want to use out, you can. I'd rather use no. but the concepts are the same. Next.
This one's from Karen K1. How do you get a dog to place for 1 or 2 hours? Is that really possible using the e-collar?
I can place a dog for 10 hours without being medicated and without a remote collar. You don't need a remote collar for anything. Guys, you don't need a remote collar for that at all. My dogs are sitting here naked. They're going to be in place for 3 hours just right now. So how do you do it? Watch my video on how to place a dog. Guys, I want you to know that it's easy to do. I want you to know that it's simple to do. Getting a dog to stay in place is simple. They don't have to be tired. I want everybody to know that. It's one of the simplest exercises to teach. In my opinion, it's simpler than teaching a dog to recall. It's simpler than teaching a dog how to spin. It's simpler than teaching a dog how to probably lie down on command, in my opinion, even though they got to lie down in place. It's just simple. So watch my video on how to train place. Start there. Then you get them to place and then down. And once they know that and they're proficient at it, when they break command, here's the magic secret sauce. Teach the dog no. When they get up, it'll be no. You put them back. And after a bunch of those repetitions, then you can start getting really firm with your no. It's easy to do. 1 hour, easy. Most dogs, after spending 1 week with us, can do it for an hour. And these are untrained dogs. Now they're trained for that. Yep. Next.
This one's from Josh. Where do I order stickers?
Go to my website, Solid Canine Training, Solid Canine Training. Hit shop and they're there. Free shipping on stickers. Next.
John Daly. Jeff, I turn everyone on to you. Thanks for calling people on the BS. My dog is tolerable because of you.
John, tolerable is not bad. We'll take that. Thanks, buddy.
Oh, Melissa put a link to the stickers.
Oh, thank you.
Russ says, good evening, Jeff and Linda. Nice to see you both.
Russ.
Nice to see you,
loving
Russ.
Your content.
Love it.
Next.
Shalanda. She was coming out of her crate, not a food stealer. That's when he growled. He also walked up to her with teeth showing when she was sniffing something today. Definitely food-based. Thank you.
Got it. So walking up to a dog, growling, the other dog is sniffing, have that dog on a leash, tell it no. Correct. But I want you to set all this up as training protocols. The last thing I want you to do is have both dogs off leash and correct one and like not be prepared for what might happen. What might happen? You might underwhelm the dog, send the dog off into even worse behavior. So everything we do has a structure and has a plan. So we don't there's no random training with our training center whatsoever. Everything is planned. Literally, we have a protocol for every single command, so all of our dog killers, we know exactly how we're going to rehabilitate them. We know what we're going to do, how we're going to do it, when we're going to do it, what tools we're going to use, what the setup's going to be, how many employees we have that we need in the room to be handling dogs. We know exactly what we're doing step by step by step. And we know historically what the options are for success and for not success. And we're prepared for both. So what I want people to understand is it is dog training. Look at it as training, like anything else out there. Next.
CJ says, hi, Jeff. Walks are good. Sirius says hi, too.
Hey, cool. Thanks, CJ.
Lou McEwen, working on leash reactivity using prong. He's great around leash dogs. However, off-leash dogs rushing him makes him uneasy. Do I correct him for growling? How do I stop the other dogs from reaching?
No, you kick the other dog. If my dogs were on a leash, which they are when I take them for walks, and an off-leash dog came towards me, the first thing I would do is try to put them behind me, and I would move forward and neutralize the threat. If a dog was getting close enough content and my dogs lunged, I wouldn't correct him. Nope. Because if my dogs are on a leash, that means we're in a leashed area, and that dog should not be off-leash, and that dog should not be approaching my dogs, and that dog should not be approaching me. And I don't care if it's aggressive or not. Dogs can't be running up to leashed dogs. No off-leash dog should ever run up to a leashed dog, friendly or not. Absolutely not. Leashed dogs shouldn't be going up to other leashed dogs. Absolutely not. That's not proper dog etiquette. That's not how you meet dogs. That's a recipe for disaster. I would love it if everybody stopped doing that. Next.
CJ says, great video.
Awesome. Thanks, CJ.
Next one's from Jay. Hey, Jeff, nothing pisses me off more than people with little dogs think it's cute and perfectly fine when their dog barks and rushes my large GSD.
Yeah, I know. So, you know, a lot more things piss me off in the world, but I hear you, buddy. I hear you. It's a problem. It's a problem.
Anna, is being aggressive when people come to our, come into our house? Why does this not make sense? He is Aussie and he is 9 months old. My parents said if it won't stop, he'll have to go. And I don't want anyone to get hurt either.
Right. So you have to stop it. It's not acceptable. No dog should be aggressive with another human being that walks up to their house. They just shouldn't. The chances of somebody breaking into your home when your dog is there and you are there is pretty slim. And if it is somebody with bad intent, well, then you don't need to ask the question because I really don't care what happens. But chances are it's going to be, you know, a friend or a relative or a delivery person, and your dog's going to bite someone, and it's only 9 months old. And I don't blame your folks for saying the dog's got to go, because if they own the house, it's their liability insurance. So even if you pay rent, it's still their home. So what I would do is keep the dog leashed and start training the dog to not do it. You have to learn how to apply a punisher to the dog. Keep the dog leashed for starters. Oh, we got squeaky chair. And then what I want you to do is role play it. Number one, does your dog know anything at all? Like basic commands. You don't have to respond here. Then somebody comes up, dog barks, correct it. Use a remote collar. No, correct with a shock collar. And everyone's going to say, oh, then the dog will have a negative association with people. Why'd you come to the, no, that's false. How do I know it's false? You came to the show and we've never spoken before. That's why I know it's false. Your dog was barking before we talked. I don't create bad behaviors. All I do is show up at the scene of the crime and fix them. I show up after the dog has behaved badly. That's all I ever do. Yes, we do some proactive training, but most of my training is after the dog has already done something wrong. That's why I know that none of the protocols, tools, philosophy, training that we do creates unwanted behaviors like everybody thinks it does. I'm the guy that comes afterwards. That's like saying the firefighter that came to the scene of the fire created the fire. No, they showed up to put the fire out. I know the fire was going on while they were there. I know when they were spraying their hoses on the fire was still probably happy.
To stop their dog. I've taught my dog to bark on command with a hand signal and it instantly changes their reaction. Ha ha. But for some reason, I am the one in the wrong.
Yeah, I know. And Jay, you're always going to be wrong because we have a bunch of entitled assholes out there. And I don't walk around mad, guys. I walk around with a smile on my face all the time. I'm just self-aware. That's why I have no problem putting my foot out for a dog, whether it's gently or firmly, because I know that the owners historically don't care. And I know that owners feel entitled. And I know that no matter what, I'm in the wrong. So I might as well keep myself and my dog safe while I'm doing it. And they're the ones with an off-leash dog. Next.
This one's from Mariah. Brought dog to daycare for first time. The temperament test process consisted of employee intro dog to other dogs while on lead a couple dogs at a time. I watched from camera. My dog had tail and legs, lying down, ears back, and showing teeth. Should I have stepped in and stopped the process? They said he passed because he didn't show aggression to fail tests. Thoughts?
I wouldn't bring my dog there. Mm-mm. I wouldn't consider that a pass. Please don't tell me who it is either, because it's not about that. I mean, could the dog come to our daycare? Well, we would train him and socialize him. The last thing I would do is want your dog to be put into a situation, your typical daycare situation, and we don't do assessments either, to be put into a typical situation where it's going to be off leash and nobody's watching your dog and all these friendly dogs are coming up to it. Now, could that dog do great really quick after 1 or 2 days? It might, but are you willing to take a chance? To me, that says nervous, concerned place to go. Or ask if they do one-on-one sessions and can we work on socialization? Next.
This one's from Anna. He got attacked Was this the one with the 9-month-old dog?
Maybe. Yeah. Yes. Yes.
He got attacked by a boar a couple months ago, and that's when it started. Yep. Please help. I don't want to give my puppy away. And I just started with a prong and e-collar.
Okay. So you don't have to, you have to say, please help. I mean, this is a free platform. Okay. So Anna, I love you. I care about you. I think you're brand new to my world, but this is a free platform. It's a Q&A platform that I can only give you an answer in 15 to 30 seconds. So it obviously fucked up your dog, but we can get past all that. But you have to understand the training process and you have to start slow. You still have to teach your dog no, whether it was attacked by a boar or not. It might have been coincidence. A lot of dogs at 9 months old start getting more reactive and aggressive-like. So all I can tell you to do is start consuming my content, train your dog, keep it on a leash. As soon as it starts barking, tell it no and correct. Prong collar and leash, no. Pop or on the remote, no. But understand distance as well. And understand your dog's triggers. The best way to do it is on a leash. Next.
This one's from Holding On Dog Training.
Yep.
Thanks for the talking to the other night. Worked through prong objections. Owner had visit and everything is golden. Can't thank you enough for what you are doing to help us.
You're welcome. Thanks for the sticker order. They should be on the way.
John Daly.
Oh, shoot.
Jay, I am right with you on that. Great GSD that could one bite kill a small dog. It avoids it, but the other dog is begging for action.
Yep.
The other owner is oblivious to the danger.
Yep.
I avoid it.
I know. Good job.
Shaw, thank you so much, sir. You're awesome. Which e-collars are good but cheap? The better ones are too expensive for me.
Okay. Unfortunately, it's not quite like a blowjob, Shaw, where there's no such thing as a bad one. What? So there's no such thing as a bad one. Okay. So you can't say cheap.
I feel like I have to go take a shower now.
Okay. Can you wait till the end of the show?
I don't know.
Okay. You want Romy to bring up like a towel?
Romy's in bed.
A towelette? A moist towel? Warm? A little schwitz? So e-collar technologies.
I could use a good schwitz.
Or Dogtra. Those are the least expensive brands that I'm going to recommend for you. Next.
I was going to compliment you on how nice that color looks on you and everything.
Thank you.
I need to go and like.
Tractor Supply, Carhartt, $9.99. Are different brands of it. And if you're brand new to my world, Max, Cena, if you heard a lot of negative stuff about it.
No, Max Cena's been on here before.
Oh, got it. I always like to segue into this respectfully to people. It's like, stick around, feel it out and just fully understand how to do it. Next.
Amanda.
Hey, Amanda.
This may be a stupid question, but my dog just got spayed. Should I wait to continue some of her training until she heals? Just basic stuff like place, heal, recall, etc.
I probably wouldn't do recall, but I would really work on duration stuff right now. You're right. Dog's got to be settled down anyway. Next.
This one's from Christy. Hi, Jeff and Mrs. Gellman. Thank you for all your content. I don't ask a lot of questions, but listen a ton for 10 minutes.
10 months.
Oh, 10 months. Hard work, but worth it. Also, stop the car sickness, like you said. Need Skype soon.
Sounds good to me. Be happy to Skype. You guys want to Skype, you go to solidcaninetraining.com. There's a Skype button there. Next.
Jasmine. Hi, Jeff. My dog gets overly excited every time we see another dog on a walk.
Mm.
He thrashes, screams, whines. We walk with a prong collar. And he otherwise walks fine and doesn't pull. Any tips?
Tons of tips. I talk about it all the time. You need to pre-bonk your dog or pre-correct your dog before the walk. And you also have to apply a punisher. Switch to a remote collar. It'll dramatically help you. Apply your punisher at the beginning of the sequence. A bonker is this, by the way. It's a wrapped-up towel. I've got a video on how to make a bonker. Or is the dog just not pulling? So where's the dog's mind at? And then at the first beginning of reactivity, you would correct. So you correct at the smallest sign of reactivity. Next.
This one's from Karen. Hi, Jeff and Linda. Thanks so much. I put my dog in place today and he didn't react when the doorbell rang and repairmen worked in the kitchen. It was awesome.
Fuck.
Thanks.
Damn. People in your kitchen? Woo! Bam. Fist bump. Fist bump for Karen. Gotta love it. Gotta love it. So I will continue to give out massive amounts of free content. I just emailed some of my social media team today. And I was like, we're still not doing enough, guys. We're still not doing enough. I need to get content out on more platforms. I need to do more work. I'm not working hard enough on this free stuff. How can we do more? So 2019, just wait. Just wait. Next.
Melissa put up a link. Anyone interested in Skyping with Jeff? Your Patreon, I think.
Oh, nice. Yep. Yeah, that's the least expensive way. Yep. Patreon, though, is fucking with people right now. So I might be jumping board. So Patreon is starting to censor people. So
jumping ship.
Jumping ship, yeah. Yep. So still do it. Still join. Don't worry. I'll let everybody know. But yeah, they're starting a pretty big censorship campaign, which I don't agree with at all. I'm big into people, you know, free speech. But I also, that doesn't mean you can threaten to kill somebody, but we won't even go there. But the exchanging of ideas to willing participants, especially on Patreon, where people have to opt into your page. See, that's the thing. People have to opt into your page. Next.
Kristen, does it matter which room a dog sleeps in its kettle at night? I keep him in my room to stop any barking with a bonker, but will that make him too attach me?
It could. It could. I would put him in the living room and put a remote collar on him instead. Next. I like dogs with behavioral issues to be out of the bedroom. That's a pretty blanket statement. Next.
Sally at C. Correction. She drops the ball. She doesn't drop objects like socks, et cetera, unless it was for a ball. Oh. She's trained. I know it. E-collar.
God. Oh, that's even easier to do. That's even easier to do. Then you don't have to worry. Then you don't have to worry about fucking up the dog. You're just going to make it suck. You pick up a sock. Oh, life is going to suck for 1 to 3 seconds. You know why? Talk to any vet or any vet tech or anybody that works in a vet office and ask them, hey, how many dogs did you get in this week that ingested socks, panties, some other, a towel, a blanket that didn't come out, and you had to take a very sharp knife and cut them open? How many? How many of them, any of them die on the table? How much does it cost? So dog picks up a sock. I'm going to keep you out of that emergency room. I'm going to make it suck for 1 to 3 seconds instead of going through surgery and the pain I'm going to have opening up my wallet. Next.
Doug in Virginia sends us a little smiley.
Hey, Doug. Well, I'd give your dog a potty. Maybe I would spend a week giving it a potty spot. Take it on a leash, go to a potty spot, tell it to go potty, or just leave it outside till it goes to the bathroom. Comes in, put it in a crate for a little bit, put it back outside. It'll eventually go. Dog sort of trained you, so flip that. Next.
Grant, how to start scent detection work?
I don't know, Grant. Grant, that's out of my skill set, so I can't ask. I don't train scent detection, so... Buddy of mine over at Van Ass Canine does. So look up Van Ass Canine, VANESS, and then canine. Next.
Cottonflower, what's your opinion on gentle leaders? Some people recommend them for reactive dogs, but I don't see how that would work.
You give it a shot. If you have a reactive dog, give it a shot. I think a lot of people are fans of them because they can pull up a little bit. And the mouth can be closed on some of the different face harnesses. It might not be the Gentle Leader brand, but it could be one of the other brands. So some people are enjoying that. Plus some people feel that they could, you can move the head away from, so if you correct at the neck, the head can still go where it wants to. But if you have a head halter on the dog and you pull away from the thing that it's reacting to, then it moves away from it. So that's most likely why people enjoy them. Next.
This one's from Jake. Hey guys, Jeff, you recommended my Dog to Edge 4-dog unit and I love it. I have a friend who needs a quality 2-dog unit. Any recommendations?
Yeah. And if you want to do the Dog to line, you can do the 282, so 282 or the 1902. They've come out with some new stuff since I've been buying Dog to, so I'm not familiar with their full line of collars. They have something called the Arc as well, or you can do an e-collar technologies 302, 402 or 802. Next.
CP Tindy. Just wanted to say thank you for all you do. Love the channel and I'm learning a lot. I'm just getting started and appreciate both your knowledge and direct approach.
Oh, thank you. Thanks for joining. Thanks for jumping on board. Really appreciate you guys. I love it so much. I think our online merch shop is going up. tonight. I think we tested the platform and now that it's working. And then I think, what day did we stay? Monday? Mm-hmm. So by Wednesday or so, we should have it.
So what's going to be there?
We've got short sleeve shirts in men's and women's. Mm-hmm. I think we have a racer back shirt in women's. Mm-hmm. And we've got hoodies. From the manufacturer we're using, they don't do zip hoodies. They only do pullovers. So we're going to have to look for another person just to do the zips. But at least we've got full hoodies on.
I feel like the zip one is going to be huge. Mm,
yeah. Well, it's not coming from this supplier for some weird reason. So this supplier can do them with embroidery, but they can't do them with, which it's got to be just a manufacturing process that for some reason they can't do it. And I don't know, because I know how to screen print and I don't know. I don't know why.
Well, you can't screen print over a zipper. So maybe that's what,
but you do the back.
Yeah, that's true.
But it's the way that the garment probably sits on the actual, but all they have to do is build a new sleeve for it. I mean, I don't know. It's not my business. Right. It's not my business. I'm not going to say, come on guys, you should do it. It's like, I believe they stock, 10 million items. It's like Jeff,
but not a zip hoodie.
It's like, no, they do, but not for the screen printing process. I don't get it. It's okay. It's fine. I'm not, it's like, okay.
Well, I look like I'm okay with it.
Next.
That's all that matters. Okay. Matt, we sent our border collie Australian Shepherd to a month-long boarding train for barking, hard to control when strangers came into house. What should we look for besides obvious improvement?
Matt, that's a question you should ask to the trainer, right? Talk to the trainer first, but you should also know that before getting into it. I mean, you should know the minimum, standards that they'll strive for. And then anything after that, sometimes we get more accomplished. You know what I mean? But I would sit down. I don't know. Cause I don't know this. Please don't mention any names. I don't allow people to mention names on my site because you'll never hear me mention another dog trainer's name. Or company names, except for a couple of my close colleagues. And it's always in a positive. I just don't think it's professional for me to make comments about people. But I would sit down and talk to them and talk to them about it. I'm not trying to not give you an answer. I don't know what their programming consists of. Next.
Lori. Following your protocol for separation anxiety, but puppy is only 2 to 3 pounds and 3.5 months old. Nonstop crying and crate when owner leaves. WWJD.
So, holy shit, 3-pound puppy, 3.5 months old. It's only 14 weeks. I'd check it out health-wise. But if it's only crying when the owner's not there, then it's not health. Then it's more of on the behavioral spectrum. So what I would do then is what's it look like when the owner is there? Most people that have a 3-pound dog are probably doing a lot of cuddling. That's probably why they got that dog. They're probably doing this. And I'm not against that, but if you got behavioral issues, you sort of got to stop. And if you don't want to create behavioral issues, first you got to put your foundational work in, which they haven't done because the dog's only 14 weeks old. So I would say, how long is that dog in the crate when they are home? How long is that dog in a calm state of mind when they are home? How much structure do they have in that dog's life when they are home? So next.
I was tapping you because there's more.
Oh.
The one says owner won't use bark or e-collar, otherwise doing everything else.
No, you don't necessarily need a bark. I mean, they don't really have a good bark collar for that size dog, at all. But I would, what I always do is for whining, someone's got to be there to tell it to shut the fuck up. Someone's got to hit the top of the crate. But since what I would always suggest is, what's it look like when they are home? Always. Next.
This one's from David. Jeff, my Belgian Malinois is possessive with food or toys with everyone but me. She growls and shows teeth and sometimes snaps. She has never bitten anyone, but I don't want that to happen.
So, David, get yourself a remote collar. Teach that dog the no word. But you also own a Belgian Malinois. Got it? You own a dog that bites, loves to bite, and frankly, we should be nurturing that bite, but not on humans. There's a big difference between controlled biting and uncontrolled biting. I would find yourself a really good sport trainer. For everybody out there that owns a Belgian Malinois, this is a wide paintbrush, comment, but more and more non-sporting people are owning Belgian Malinois. Be careful what you ask for. Be careful what you ask for. Number one, the reason why you see most really well-trained and behaved Belgian Malinois is because they've got owners, and David, this doesn't make you a bad owner at all, but they've got owners with a certain level of training ability that's on the higher spectrum of, they're definitely not dog owners, they're dog trainers, and they can do incredible things with that dog because that is one of the most drivey, powerful dogs out there. When I mean powerful, I'm not talking about like necessarily like knocking over someone power or biting, but they can actually with their intense drive. But you've got yourself a very unique athletic specimen of a canine. And what you're going to do though is teach that dog that it's not acceptable. Best way to do that is with a remote collar. But I highly encourage everybody that owns most power breed dogs, but especially a Malinois, to find a trainer. Find a trainer that can help you. Next.
Albert. Yup, had my APBT on leash at a park specifically because of leash regulation at the park on a trail. Yep. So lo and behold, a couple had about 10 dogs off leash with
holy
three or four coming directly
shit.
At us. Assholes.
Albert, number one, I'd bring a video camera. I'd bring a friend with a video camera, and you have bear spray. And like, yeah, that's bad. That's bad. Yep. Now, if you want to have an off-leash dog, that's fine. But you better be able to call it out of drive. You better be able to call it out of drive. And if you can't, your dog will suffer consequences. And don't think I go around hurting dogs or kicking dogs. I go around, I make sure that I, myself, my children, I'm old school, my wife, and my dogs are kept safe. Sorry, I'm an extremely non-violent, non-aggressive human being. But when it comes to like personal safety, if someone's going to get hurt, I don't want it to be anybody in my circle. Nope. Sorry. So unfortunately, those other dogs will have to pay the price for their owner's stupidity. And of course, it's not their dog's fault, but it sure as hell ain't my fault, and it's not my dog's fault. So it's happening more and more as we live in a society with a lot of entitled human beings that feel that the rules don't apply to them. Next.
Nikki, just got a mini educator today. I've consumed much of your content and I'm gearing up to start training. My GSD is 8 months and becoming rebellious. Just wanted to thank you so much for all your content.
Awesome. Get going, man. Get started now. 8 months. Don't wait. Should have started a long time ago, but I won't give you a hard time about that. Next.
Morgan. Hey, Jeff from Instagram was asking about correcting. I don't know why I can't read this. I was asking
arousal.
How correcting creates more arousal.
Yep.
His structure is almost 100% of the time.
Yep.
Place, playing, or training. Aggression is owner-based and seems random.
Okay. So, Morgan, this is what happens. A lot of times, not a lot of times, there are times when if you correct a dog, what you do is you send the dog into a higher aroused state, which can make the behavior worse. We see that once in a while. We see some dogs go into defense as well. A lot of times that's a timing issue. It's a timing issue. What you're not doing is you're not catching it early enough, and you're driving the arousal instead of squashing the arousal. So you need to catch it extremely early. What does that look like? Say the dog. Kira, here. Place. Plots. Something's going on over there. Text.
What do you mean?
I don't know. Something weird's going on. What you're going to do is say your dog is dog reactive. What you're going to do is have your dog, you take it for a walk. As soon as it slightly recognizes the other dog, correct. Correct high at the small infraction. That's what I want you to do. Also, what's the rest of the day look like with the owners? How much structure? Next.
This one's from Morgan. See you at the Florida show. What can I expect at one of your seminars? Bringing him looking for help.
A lot of fun. So you're gonna find it's a really good time. It's 16 hours to 18 hours of content. I will push you and I will push your dog farther than you ever thought you can go. You will laugh. You will cry. We will hug. There is complimentary snacks. There is.
I know. Just the way you said it.
Okay. There's complimentary. I got this itch right there. There's complimentary snacks. I can say it with like, I can say it like a cocky son of a bitch because I've done almost 150 of these seminars. That's over 3,000 people. And I'm telling you, we kill it at these seminars. We kill it. And I love so many people's lives are being changed. They're fantastic. They're fantastic. I want to do one every weekend, but then I would be living in my RV permanently because I don't think Linda would put up with it. Next.
Fernando from Guatemala just gave us all these really cool thumbs up. And I'm thinking that if you clapped it out and did that, that it might be a song.
Cool. It could be sign language. Next.
It could be.
Next.
Cotton flower.
Thanks, Fernando.
Watch your mouth. Jeff, there are children present, LOL.
Oh, well. So, it's funny. Angelo, we are down in Florida. And I'm a big Gary V fan, Gary Vaynerchuk. And I was watching one of his videos, and he learned it from a video. So, I told him, that's not acceptable behavior. You're not allowed to say that word at all. And I actually swear in front of my kids. Like, believe it or not, Angelo was in the room. I probably wouldn't say fuck as much, but he definitely has heard me say fuck before. He won't say ship, S-H-I-P.
He won't say crab.
He won't say crab either. Okay? So, because it sounds too similar to a word he's not supposed to say.
And our kids won't say, the older kids won't say special shit about the season.
I know. And then also, Angelo, we let him watch electronics. And for some reason, when he pressed a video, the video said, some video said either, I think it said shit or something. He freaked out. Oh my, I'm so sorry, Papa. I'm so sorry, Papa. I'm like, Angelo, it's okay. Don't worry. It's fine. He got really upset that like his tablet played a video that said shit. Cause it was like, that means he said it. So this concept that, you know, you don't swear around your kids. This isn't directed at you. It just reminded me of a story. And I know I'm going on too long, but it's like, no, teach your kids the difference between right or wrong. You'd be surprised what they're capable of doing, even when wrong is all around them. Next.
The mama bear. I have been following for a while and want to help my out of control chihuahua, but I haven't seen you work with any tiny breeds. I'm wondering if tools and methods are the same.
Pretty much. We don't get a lot of tiny breeds in because a lot of people don't want to work with their tiny breeds. But yes, the methods are the same. This is standard dog training theory that I'm doing of reward and punishment. So it's exactly the same. Next.
Melissa says, I think Fernando is saying hugs from Guatemala.
Thank you so much.
All right, hugs.
We'll take it.
Yeah.
He's definitely not saying fuck you because I don't see any middle finger. So as far as I'm concerned, I'll take it. Next.
Allie.
Hey, Allie Wynn.
Hi, Jeff and Linda. Late from work, so we'll have to watch replay. Hope your daughter is feeling better.
She is. Thank you, Allie Wynn. Thanks for sharing your story on Instagram. Next.
Josh. I don't know if my dogs are cat aggressive, reactive, or not. How do I introduce my grandpa's cat? I will be watching him for 2 weeks.
Well, I don't know. How sick of a person are you? I mean, you could just let the cat go. And
do you like a good pelt?
That's right.
I love a good pelt.
So, I mean, you need a new hat. I mean, you do anything. I mean, it's the kind of thing where I would plan on keeping the cat separate. Okay, next.
Jordy. 16-week GSD puppy was social, but now it's starting to bark while walking, and he walks on a prong collar.
Jordy, that makes the dog normal. Got it? He's 16 weeks old. What I want you to do is pick up a book on maybe The Monks of Newskeet or Caesar Milan, or there's a couple of other books on the different ages, correlating the ages of the dog, the weeks of the dog to different fear stages in the dog and what some things is to be expected. And try to get them from a few multiple sources on that. Don't listen to any of the bullshit that don't use a prong collar on a 16-week-old puppy, because that's a lie. Of course you can. German Shepherd dog, dragging your ass down the street, of course you can. But just tell the dog no and then correct. So it's normal puppy raising problem that you're experiencing. Next.
Blue One Black. People don't forget to hit the like button to help this channel.
Thank you, Blue on Black. I definitely don't tell people to love me as much as they should. Hit the like button, hit the like show, subscribe to my channel. Thank you so much. Thank you, Blue on Black. Next.
This one's from Jasmine. Thanks.
Keep it up. You can always add one more of the of what you're doing into the mix. Just add an add a second one or a third one. Yeah. And then work on duration stuff. Nice job. Next.
Kathleen.
Good, Kathleen.
My Husky Shepherd mix is super energetic, approximately 2 to 3 years old. She wants to be outside most all of the time. Her nature. Is it not good to let her spend more time on inside?
What do you want from your dog? I mean, I own an outside dog. I've had a couple of outside dogs. We live in the city. Like, I live right in Providence, Rhode Island. I've got houses all around me. But I own an outside dog. If I had land, I'm actually looking at land tomorrow. I'm looking at 20 acres of land tomorrow with a horse barn on it. What I'm going to do with it, I don't know. I might not even, I mean, I'll put it this way. I'm looking at it. So not to live on. Linda's not going to live there. But I don't know.
I had a vision.
Did you? Do you want to?
I had a vision about turning the barn into our house.
No, I would rent it out to horses. But
I'm not interested.
If you want to live in a barn, I mean, that just build a damn barn. This barn you probably don't want to live in. It's probably be cheaper to just build a new barn. Anyway, the point is that maybe let it spend more time outside. You know, I love outside dogs. I love outside dogs. Next.
You got a
Canadian chat. Canadian 5. Jenna. Hey, Jenna. Your content is helping me so much with my dog, reactive dog, also working with trainer who shadowed Sean O'Shea. P.S. You and Collingwood. Awesome. Yeah, Sean's my buddy. He's a good guy. Good job. His name I mentioned on my show. I'll even mention his website, thegooddog.net.
Oh, you're such a nice guy.
Yeah, I always do. Yeah, he's a great guy. Next.
Tiffany. Do you use prong collars on toy breeds when on structured walks?
Yeah, we make a 175. Well, not necessarily. I mean, but you get some of these little toy breeds that are out of control. It's a good way. It's a good way. I mean, to me, a prong collar is like the most humane, user-friendly, owner-empowering tool to use. So, yeah, next.
Mariah.
Hey, Mariah.
My dog loves to eat inedible items. Mm. Oh, shiz. Made it suck on maximum level for 3 seconds. 2 minutes later, she went back for it.
Wow.
Made it suck again and again or some. Make it suck again and again or something else?
I would check fit on the collar. And you might need a more powerful collar. If you're using the Dog Truth, the Mini Educator 300, that's their lowest level collar. They make a boss. We have some dogs that need a double boss, meaning two boxes like this, very powerful. A lot of our dog aggressive dogs might need something like that. So, you know, yeah, you really have to make it, you got to make it really suck sometimes. So I would check fit next.
Sally at sea. Springer again. One last correction. Ha ha. She doesn't swallow objects. Just destroys. Only when I'm home. Clearly for attention. I tried ignoring. Like I said, e-collar ordered. Collingwood 2019.
Salty at sea? Okay. You know what I'm going to say about the ignored. If I walked up to you and grabbed your tits, if you're a female? Salty at sea? Whatever.
It's Sally.
Sally. Oh, that's why you said Sally. So, I guess you could be a male named Sally. Yeah. I mean, there are men named Sally.
I had an Uncle Sal. I think people called him Sally.
I'm going to assume you're a female, not because your name is Sally, but just to make the story more relevant. If I grabbed your tits and you ignored me, do you really think I'd stop? No. Guys, stop ignoring bad behaviors. They don't go away. They'll never go away. So what do? I don't want your dog picking up a sock. It could die. And for attention, that's not attention. Okay. Teach your dog to tell you a joke or sing a Broadway show. Sing a Broadway tune. Next.
This one's from Shaw. LMAO. You should also be a stand-up comedian. We need more people like you. Thank you so much, sir. I don't know about that.
I don't know about that either.
I don't know.
I'm mystic.
I don't think you're that funny.
Shaw, I'm mystic to podcasts. Thanks.
He's not funny.
Okay. Yeah, we heard you the first time.
Yeah. Sahar Sen. Our youngest son, Max, an 11-year-old, gets no respect from our dog, Orion, 7 years old. They grew up together. How do we get Orion to obey Max?
I just thought of Rodney Dangerfield right there for a second. No respect. I get no respect. Some of you might not even know who Rodney Dangerfield is.
I don't know who that is.
Really?
I'm just kidding.
I was going to say, are you serious? No respect. So What I would do is you can't just expect the dog to respect the child. What's the child done or not done? And I don't mean harming the dog. Like everyone always goes down that street. What I would do is this, I would teach the dog to obedience commands and then teach your child how to handle the dog, and you supervise it, and then you let them take it from there. That's what I would do next.
This one's from Shayna.
Hey, Shayna.
Hi, Jeff. Linda, just wanted to finish what I told you Saturday about bringing chocolate to Jersey seminar, peanut butter cups, cherry cups.
You can email me a list. Email me a menu. Thank you. Let's see.
Wait, I don't know what's going on. What is?
She said she's going to be going to, she's bringing baked goods to the Jersey seminar. And I was like, don't. Joelle got all excited. Oh. So I'm probably going to have to bring a lockbox with me. Because Joelle travels in the RV because she documents everything and helps out at the seminars. I can see her getting up in the middle of the night snacking, and I would never know.
I don't see that happening.
You don't?
No, I don't.
Why?
Because I don't think she's that type of person.
To what?
To snack in the middle of the night like that.
Really? Huh.
Am I wrong? Call her right now.
I'll ask her tomorrow. I can see her giving into her temptations of sweets.
I think so.
Well, the Jersey seminar is a weekend show. We're going there. We're coming back.
Okay.
In other words, we're on the road for 4 days. Mm-hmm. So I can see her possibly not having to, if we had to drive around with those sweets in one of the cabinets for like one of the 2 week stints we did, and we got that at the beginning, I can see her breaking.
All right, whatever.
Next.
This one's from David. Just started teaching my dog place last week. Sometimes she rolls around until she is mostly off the bed. Should I pull her back onto the bed completely? Thanks for all the free content.
Yes, pull her back. Tell her to cut the shit. Next.
Albert.
Oops.
That's a great idea. I will grab some bear spray and a... You know what?
Camera. Yep.
Thanks, Linda and Jeff. Love this show.
Albert, thanks for jumping on. Next. Okay. Don't keep reading the sweets from Shanna. Next.
Oh, I mean cherry marshmallow cups plus chocolate covered apples. For the kids, and chocolate vodka candy, even peanut butter is homemade. Bring a big cooler. Get a Yeti. That's it. I need a Yeti. And you will bring me a cooler full of treats.
I loved how nonchalant you were. And you were just like, no, she won't do it. And all of a sudden you see all that and you go nuts. Now, do you think she's going to do it or not?
No.
Oh, you still don't?
I still don't.
Okay.
She has a lot more self-control than either one of us.
No. I woke her ass up almost every morning to go to the gym.
I'm not talking about that. I'm talking about the food issues.
All right.
All right. Linda, how long does the whole Q&A stay on YouTube to rewatch? They have been disappearing pretty quick.
So they disappear almost instantly, but they reappear. And this is why. What we're doing is we're taking the show and we've got to add a beginning, an intro to it and an end screen to it. So in order to do that, we take the show, we make it private. All right. We do what we're going to do to it, and then we relaunch it. So we don't delete any content, but by watching it live, we don't have any links that you can link out to other than what Melissa puts up. But nothing can go on the screen at all. There's nothing that gets embedded on the screen. And that's what we want to do for future people. So that's why. But they all get relaunched. Go to my videos. They're all there. Every show is there. Next. I think 489 was just put up. I think they're like a week. They stay up for maybe up to a week. Next.
Tammy, love you guys. Can't wait for Reno seminar.
Reno's going to be fun, Tammy. Can't wait to see you.
Nikki, what I mean to say is I am now starting e-collar training on my 8-month-old GSD thanks to you and all of your content.
Oh.
I've been training him the entire time.
Oh, Nikki, yeah. Yeah, it's fine. Even if you didn't, I wouldn't be mad at you. But thanks for the clarification.
Do we read this?
I love you. I love you. No matter, I love you no matter what, Nikki. So cool. I'm glad you're, and that's, you know, and that you're going to have a great time. You're going to really have a great, especially if your dog has a good foundation, just layer the remote collar over the foundation. Next.
You know what you can get me as a Christmas gift? A Yeti cooler.
What the fuck would you do with a Yeti cooler? Are you going deer hunting?
No, we'll put all the candy and the treats and everything in the Yeti cooler.
Do you know that this, I'll have the new RV then. The new RV has got a 4-door fridge. It's huge.
You can't have the stuff in the fridge, though.
Why not?
Because it'll get eaten.
By whom? Not by me. Oh, no. Uh-uh.
Oh, no.
How do you think this guy... Oh, no. How do you think I lost 20 pounds? How do you think this is... This I'm starting to look like a lean...
This physique?
This physique is shaping. Willpower, like you wouldn't believe. Incredible willpower. Next.
It's cute.
I'm not buying you a Yeti cooler.
I'm joking. You think I really want a Yeti cooler?
No, you want cash. Next.
Andrea, what would be the best way to introduce my 16-week GSD puppy to my dad's pack of 5 9-month-old GSDs when two are territorial and one not at all social?
You don't, Andrea, let me be really serious here. This is probably the most serious statement I've said this whole show, other than when I tell people I love them, because I truly do. Don't bring your dog to your dad's house. Don't let your dog's dogs come to your house. I don't want your dog around those dogs. I would never bring any of my dogs to your father's house. No disrespect to your father as a human being or as a dog owner. But I would never bring any of my clients' dogs or any of my dogs into that situation at all. Please do not bring your dog over there at all. Even if your father says he will cut you out of the will and he'll never talk to you again, unless you want a dead dog. So if you want the money and your father's love, but a dead dog, bring it over. And I'm still being 100% serious, because some people manipulate others like that. Don't do it. Please, please, please do not do it. Next.
This one's from Michelle. My brother passed last month, did the slow intro, and followed your advice. 3 dogs and puppy now spend several hours a day together. Cat loose at night while dogs kenneled and locked away for day. Thanks for all you do.
Wow. Your brother passed? Did you get his dogs? Fuck, Michelle, what happened? Oh, my God. I think I remember that. So sorry about your brother. My God, sorry for your loss. Terrific. I'm glad it's working out. Sorry, I can't answer another goddamn question now. It's terrible. Cool. Glad it's working out. Slow and steady is really, really important. Next.
Oh, P.S. The kitty was my brother's.
The cat. Got it. Okay. I got it now. Next.
Sahersen. It was definitely a Rodney Dangerfield reference.
Thanks. All right. Thanks. Next.
Didn't Rodney Dangerfield come out with like a song that was kind of like a rap, and you I'm sure no respect I'm, no respect
I don't think people realize that Rodney Dangerfield was around before social media existed, and like how big he got, and just the power that we all have right now with social media. Next. Yeah. Siobhan. Yes.
Hi guys, we have had our cats for 8 years. Yep. I can't see this. And now we have adopted 2 American bulldogs, right. Sorry, this past year. Cats have been downstairs since the summer, afraid to introduce. What would Jeff do?
Jeff would tell you not to do it unless someone with lots of experience was there. Guys, don't mix. You got to be super careful about these intros. I don't know your skill set. So, Siobhan, I don't know your skill set, and I don't know the dogs. And breed doesn't matter. Jack Russell can kill a cat. You know what I mean? So, you know, I don't know your dogs. And then there's 2 of them. They can feed off of each other. And next thing you know, you got a pack attack. They can also trigger a fight with each other. I've seen that happen before. So it would be done on with remote collar and leash. What I would do, you see, there's a couple ways to do it. We do this in my seminars, by the way. I use chickens if I have access to a chicken. I've done rats. I've had access to rats because people do barn hunting at some of these. I don't do barn hunting, but there's barn hunting at the where I do the seminars at. And I'll use cats. And we always do them in a crate historically. One seminar, we did walk a cat on a leash. In Providence, walked a cat on a leash.
We tried to put our cat on a leash, right, but he wasn't happy.
I think I got someone's cat. Yeah. Mm. So we've done that. And I do a lot of stuff with kids too. So, but with the dog, there's a lot of variables to use. So on this quick show, I can't really get into it, how we would do it. The remote collar on, there's a couple of different options. You can make it suck to go after the cats, but still, there's a lot of different protocols on that one. Next.
Mama Bear. Just following up on my Chihuahua question, I ordered a mini educator, but it's too big for her tiny neck. Help.
You should have gotten the micro educator. There's no good remote collar for a dog under 6 pounds, but you want to get the micro, not the mini.
Who fits the micro then?
You could get a micro, is a little bit fatter. You can put it on the back of the dog's neck. Sometimes you can actually even take the remote collars, put them inside, and stitch them into a harness as well. So Next.
No, but I was just wondering, isn't that micro one made for a tiny dog?
Yeah, but not as tiny as you'd think.
Not a 5 pound dog?
It's still going to be big and bulky. Yep. What you want to do
Can't you replace the actual
You get rid of, dog? Yeah, you get rid of the strap and you can get a Velcro strap. You get something with Velcro on it so you can really cinch it snug.
And you can cut it. You
can cut it as well. But you're going to struggle. You're going to struggle. It's hard. Next.
Angie.
Hey, Angie.
I didn't realize I had been using okay as well as free to release my dogs from place, down, etc. until I said okay to my kids and they jumped off of place. Is it going to be a pain to break this?
No. Just now you make sure you say free and highly reinforce that, and then you put a punisher if you say okay. Next.
Shayna, if you really are interested in getting a horse farm, I can help with that. I'm former equestrian, also taught Special Olympics, teaching autistic children, HW to ride.
Well, how to ride.
How to ride. I don't understand. Right. I can't. Maybe you could do something like that.
So Chenna, thank you so much for your kindness. The cool thing is I have two jumper people on my staff. Who ride, and one of them, and they both are teachers too. And I just hired a farmhand too to work in my kennel. She's been mucking. This girl's 18 years old. She's been mucking stalls since she was 8.
Wow.
Yeah. So if it goes there though, we'll see how far I go with this. If I go with this, I have no idea. I'm just looking for different things right now. I'm looking for different things. I got a lot of good ideas in my head, and I'm just wanting to see how far they go. So, and also I'm in the market to buy property. I own two houses in Florida. I thought about buying another one. I thought about buying a cabin in the Catskills because I Airbnb them out. If you guys aren't on Cheap Old Houses, jump on Cheap Old Houses on Instagram. I'm on that site daily looking at all the different houses. Almost every house is stunning and they're under $100,000. A bunch of them have been showing up in Canada. In Prince Edward Island, two of them just showed up. For 59,000 Canadian, one for 74,000 Canadian. There's a lot of different things that my mind is always going into. Next.
Debbie.
Oh wow, haven't seen you for a long time,
I know,
Debbie.
Right?
Hey Debbie, how are you?
Ruby and I are doing good. Merry Christmas.
Oh, thank
love.
You. Merry Christmas to you.
Merry
Happy
Christmas,
holidays.
Debbie. Yep. Tiffany, my son got me a pink Yeti cooler.
Nice.
Hello.
Bucky's has got a lot of them. They got knockoff Yetis now too. Next.
Yeah, you know I don't like fake.
I know you don't. I used to buy handbags. Never again. Next.
Oh, please. Andrea. Oh my God. Thank you so much for letting me know.
Oh, good, Andrea. Thank you. Thank you for taking it seriously. I'm being serious. If you ever watched my show before, you know I'm like sarcastic sometimes and I make rude comments and things like that. But when I'm serious, I hope you felt that. Next.
I ski Big Sky, hi Linda and
Montana.
Jeff.
Montana.
Hello. Andrew, found your channel last week, been bonking ever since. Thanks.
You know what I want to say is like,
it sounds dirty
and
like, too.
And your dick is raw. I'm sorry. Oh, shit. Andrew, I had to. Guys, who's with me on this? I had to, right? Please. I had to. Write in the comments. Somebody.
Don't cross me. All of you.
Please. Somebody support me.
You pick my side or you'll see what happens.
Please.
There will be no more YouTube live.
Please. So please support me, guys. Next. Good. Andrew, proud of you, buddy. Next.
Fiorella. I have a 5.5-month-old GSD puppy barking at other dogs on walks. Do you think this is just puppy behavior? He will outgrow it?
No.
Best way to correct it?
Okay. Three-part question. Is it puppy behavior? Eh, could be. Will he outgrow it? Absolutely not. Best way to correct it? Prong collar on the dog, leash on the dog, dog barks, no, pop. Remote collar on the dog, with a, you know, walk the dog, dog barks, no, remote collar. You stop it. Next.
Mario.
Hey.
Thank you for giving us dog training advice and sometimes marital advice. Any advice on how to make a teenager keep her room clean?
Actually, this is my advice for the teenager thing. Close their door and don't look inside. And when they move out, get 2 gallons of paint, bunch of construction bag, contractor bags, go in there, get all the crap out of there, all right? And repaint the room. That's pretty much the advice. My big thing is no food. I don't want food wrappers in there. I don't want any glassware in there. I don't want any, you know, takeaway boxes in there. I don't want any dirty plates in there. Have enough respect to at least put your food down. I don't believe that you should withhold electronics for a clean room. I don't believe that you should withhold allowance for a clean room. One of our teenage daughters graffitied her room. We have a beautiful house that was built in 1903. She graffitied her room. And you know what? When she moved out, now putting holes in the room, like holes, no, you can't do that. But if you want to take paint and paint stuff on it and marker and you want to draw on the wall, you know, you can. It's your room and we're going to paint it anyway. So if you would have ruined a wall, I would have, you know, we do all sheetrock here and plaster. I would have just had somebody come in. I mean, you know, to me, I like to, you know, and is it a good kid? Is it a good kid?
I also think that some kids are naturally neat and some kids just aren't. Like Clover keeps a very
Clover keeps barely anything in room
Romy's
or neat.
Romy's room looks like a tornado hit.
Romy's always looks like a tornado hit. Always, always. And to me, keep the door closed so you don't have to visually see it. Next. And then also stay out of the room. Next. Next.
Andrea, yeah. Hold on, it's blocked by the little arrow. Mm-hmm. All while my GSD is peeing every single time he greets my family members that come to my house, I try to correct with prong collar. It does not work.
No, don't do that. So Andrea, Andrea, you probably should do, if you got a puppy and you're struggling, especially a German Shepherd, I mean, not that it makes it any harder, but it's going to be a big, powerful dog. Probably should jump on a Skype or join, you know, probably jump on a Skype with me. What you want to do is I would start making sure you got a really good routine for structure as far as your housebreaking routine, your potty training routine, your crate training routine. Second of all, I would start teaching the place command. And then what I would do is I would start telling family members to, I don't want any high-pitched voices. I don't want any excitement. I want you to come in and ignore the dog for a little bit and then allow the dog to just be, you know, exist. Calm around the dog is excited. Excited voices, high-pitched voices, lots of like, you know, stuff like this. Dog jumps up on them. It's always gonna end up with pee. And I don't wanna be correcting my dog for that. I'd rather be, when it comes to bathroom stuff, I'm highly proactive and do a lot of self-blaming if the dog has an accident. Meaning it's like, I fucked up, it's my fault. Next.
Dirty sock box.
Hey.
Hi guys, my dog is scattered and unfocused on walks. How can I refocus? I use a prong with him.
What I want you to do is the very beginning of the walk, let that dog know we're going on a structured walk. Try my 180 move. Go to my YouTube channel, type in 180. By the way, if you guys haven't subscribed to my YouTube channel, just hit subscribe right there. Turn on your notifications as well. Do the 180 move. What you want to do is just start your walk off with a really good, like, hey, pay attention to me. Next.
Dirty Sock Box also says, ha ha, yes.
Next.
Andrew, I'm originally from the UK.
Oh, nice. I know. Bonking. So he understands bonking. Next.
I lost it.
Michelle says he had to. Patrick says you had to. Raquel said, I will read these. Raquel will say, Linda's face is priceless. I love you, Linda.
Love you too,
Dirty Sock Box says, hashtag had to. Sorry, guys. RTIC coolers are just as good, if not better, than Yeti. Tonight's been fun, nice, and educational. Very good. Andrew says, I've been using verbal marker. Do you think a clicker's better? So, Andrew, I think a verbal mark, okay, start the dog on a clicker and switch to yes, and then have some fun. It's impractical, but I think clickers give you, and I used to be against clickers just because I didn't know them and understand them. So clickers give you way better timing. You can get a lot more motivation sometimes out of dogs. And you definitely can sometimes do a better job with a clicker. So try with a clicker, but switch to yes. Next.
Flibber Slooper. I can't even say it. Saharsen is my better half. Trying to keep things calm with two dogs when I enter the house. Keep a bonker by the door, but my aim sucks. I've missed a couple of times. Got to step up my bonking game.
You got to. Are you guys still together? That's the couple that was like, that's the couple.
I don't know what you're talking
about. Yeah, we just did a, it's coming out. They were on the show together, and I got in between them. I was getting in. She's the one that talks about me 24/7. Was that?
No,
I'll show you the meme. It's not a meme. I'll show you the clip. I think it's coming out this week. Huh. But anyway, step up your game. Yes. Next.
This is Key MD. Yes. Not a training question. Went to a pet store for food. A dog training class was taking place. All dogs with harnesses. Frustrated lady due to bulldog not obeying. Wanted to tell her to watch Jeff G on YouTube Live.
Don't do that. They'll hate you. Stay in your lane. So, Keem, just stay in your lane. Stay in your lane. I stay in my lane. Next.
Dirty Sockbox says I have done the 180 and bonk, but it's short-lived and back to scattered.
Switch to a – get it. Jump on a remote collar. Jump on a remote collar. Make your life easier. Next.
I ski Big Sky. It's not worth the fight. Just shut the door. They will be gone one day, so enjoy them and don't fight about every little thing. You guys nailed it.
Cool. Next.
Dave, any tips for getting consistent e-collar contact with our golden doodle on a dog for Art? 10-month-old and her adult fur has come in fierce. Also, thanks for your content. I'm doing the work with this silly dog, and it's a game changer for the dog and my family.
Awesome. One thing, get yourself thick fur contact points. You can get them from e-collar technologies. They fit on the dog for 280 in the 1900. They should fit on the arc. I'm trying to picture the arc. If you're unscrewing the arc's contact points and there's a post there, they should fit on them. They should fit on them. Yes.
Shayna, can I put a 2.25 prong collar on Mini Doberman? He's a nervous dog and can be nasty at times. What about an e collar for him?
Yes and yes. Next.
Andrew says, when you feed raw, what do you use for food luring and reward?
That's a good question. You can always use dried liver treats, which you can get store-bought. A lot of, you can also make your own stuff. You can just make your own stuff. So you can get some sort of, figure out what your ingredient's going to be, get a food dryer, dehydrate a bunch of stuff, and then you break it up or cut it up. Next. Someone's dreaming. Girl. Next. Up, 132. Guys, let's go do a couple more. There's one last one. What's the difference between your Skype 60-minute dog training versus business? Mariah, business people pay more for my Skype. I'll let you guys know how to beat the system with me, okay? If you want to do a Skype with me, a business Skype, it's 60 minutes of it is $250 for business because you own a business. I'm helping you build your business. And it's just you pay
you
more.
Did you say 60 minutes?
Yeah.
It sounded like you said 16 minutes.
No, 60-minute Skype. Because and I'm charging you. That's what I'm doing. So you're paying more for the service. If you do a 30-minute Skype on Patreon, if you're a Patreon member for $100 a month, you get a 30-minute Skype a month. You can always add a 30-minute to that. So, you know, you go on a Patreon and you'd be better off doing a 30-minute one every month. A lot of people do. Or just pay for the 60-minute one first, and then you can switch over to a 30-minute. All right, guys, we got to go. We have to go.
Yeah, we got to go.
Yeah. That was Patrick. That was girl. Linda, love you too. Dirty Socks, you're welcome. Peter Yee, teach my high energy Siberian Husky to stay in place for extended periods of time using prong collar. But yeah, just watch my video on place. Watch the video on place. All right, guys, we have got to go. I only have Linda on contract till 9:30 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. It's 9:35. I was already punched once tonight. She's going to punch me again. Will I see everybody? Yeah, today's only Monday. I'll see everybody Wednesday, Saturday, and Monday again before Christmas.
Saturday, we are at the ballet.
Oh, shit. We do a Friday night show?
Me?
Oh, you don't do them anyway.
And I can't. I'm volunteering at the ballet.
Let me see if Joelle can do a Friday night show instead of Saturday. Oh, shit. She has to. She's
sorry. All right, stop mumbling. We'll
Wednesday,
figure it out.
Wednesday. I'm just trying to think of the schedule. Wednesday, you'll see us Wednesday night, 8 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. All right, guys. Boom. Love you. Thanks.